This is Srinivas Lakim. Today we are going to see how to create files. To create files, we have multiple commands: cat command, touch command, vir vim command, vim or nano. So these cat, touch are commands, vir vm, nano, these are editors. So by using commands we can create files. By using editors also we can create files. These two are editors. Okay, let's see first cat command. By using cat we can create files. By using cat we can create files and we can see the content of file. We can see the content of file. Content of file. File or files. Okay. So by using cat what? We can create files. We can create a file. And we can see the content of file. We can see the content of file. File or files. Next, we can append the content. We can append the content. We can append the content to existed file. Existed file. Okay. By using cat command, we do three operations. Let's see how to create a file. Create a file. See, cat, this is greater than symbol and file name. So this is redirection operator. So cat greater than file name. This command first checks whether specified file is already available or not. If file is not available, it will create file. First it will check, specified file. Specified file is available or not. If it is not available, it will create file. It will create file and opens file in write mode. If file is already if file is already available it opens file in overwrite mode. Do you know what is overwrite mode? It will remove existed content, it will write new content. Okay? Let's see practically. In fundamentals, there is no file and directory. I am creating a file called data types. Okay, and here I am writing content like Java has 8 data types. They are byte, short, etc. After this, I am saving this content. To save this file and to come out from editing prompt, we use Control D. Control D. So to save and come out from file, we use Control. This is Control symbol D. When you press Control D, it will save content and control comes out of editing. Okay. Then to see the content of file, we use command call cat file name. Okay, cat file name is what? Data types. So this is the content. Again, I am trying to create a file called data types. So I am trying to create file called data types. This data types file already available, right? If file is already available, what this will do? It will open a file in overwrite mode, right? In overwrite mode, what will happen? It will remove existed content. So I am writing some message, some data, and I am saving this file, Control D. Next, I want to see the content of file, data types. See, old data is removed, new data is saved. So when you use this operation for creating files, if file is not available, it will create new file. If file is already available, it will open file in overwrite mode. Next one, how to append the content to existed file? Append content to existed file. So for that one, we use command cat command. Here we use greater than and file name. So here, this command first will search whether file is already available or not. First it will check whether file is already available or not. If file is not available, it will create file and opens file in write mode. If file is already available, then it will open file in append mode. In append mode, cursor is placed after last line, last character. Okay, let's see practically. Cat greater than data types, then I am entering welcome to Sinotech. Welcome to Linux world. By Mr. Akim Srinivaslu. Then to save and come out from this file, we use Control D. How to see the content of file? cat file name data types. See, previously we have hello, recently we enter welcome Srinutech, welcome to Linux, and by Mr. Akkam Srinivaslu. So this content is appended to existed file, right? Okay, so if you want to append content to existed file, we use this cat command. Okay, next command is touch command. Next command is touch command. If you see cat command, by using cat command we can create only one file at a time. We cannot create multiple files. By using cat command we can create only one file at a time. We cannot create multiple files at a time. If you want to create multiple type files at a time, we use touch command. Touch creates multiple files at a time. It will create at a time with empty data. So we can create empty files, any number of empty files at a time. We use command touch F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6. Like this you can create any number of files at a time. Let's see practically. ls, see currently we have only one file. I want to create multiple files. Touch F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6. Press enter. ls, it is created multiple files without any content. Cat command creates file with content. If you enter content, the content is presented in file, but we can create only one file at a time. If you want to create multiple files at a time, we use what? Touch command. But touch will create multiple files at a time without any content. Okay? So if you want to create multiple files with content, we have one more command called t command. Let's see t command. So I am using t and file name is linux 11 linux 22, and I am entering content hello, welcome to Linux world. See, observe, if you use t command, we are creating multiple files, right? So it will write the same content in two files at a time. You enter content and press enter, it is writing content into two files. Ctrl D. It will save and come out. Cat Linux 11, see the same content. Cat Linux 22, same content. So if you use cat command, it will create one file at a time with content. If you use touch command, it will create multiple files without data. If you use t command, we can create multiple contents with data, but same data. Okay, next one, vi or vim. Vi or vim is a editors. Vi stands for visual editor. visual editor. By using VI, we can create files, we can write content, we can see the content. We can see the content of file. Okay? Vim is an advanced version of VI. Vim is a new editor. It is an advanced version of VI. Okay? Let's see how to create files by using VI. We use command call VI and file name. I am using file 1. When you press enter, it will open a file. VI has three modes. VI has three modes. VI editor has VI or Vim editor has three modes. One, command mode. Two, insert mode. Insert mode. Three, colon mode. Colon mode. Colon mode. Colon mode. Okay. Insert VI has three modes. Command mode, insert mode, and colon mode. Okay. So here, if you want to insert data into this file, we have to enter into insert mode. By default, it is in command mode. By default, it is in command mode. So default mode is command mode. This is default mode. Default mode. In this default mode, we apply some commands. We apply some commands. Commands like copy content, copy content, paste content, delete lines, etc. We apply some commands. Next, insert mode. Insert mode, we enter data, we modify data, and we edit data. Okay, in colon mode, we also called it is execution mode. Execution mode. In execution mode, we save the content, content or quit editor, etc. We do some operations here. Okay, so first I want to enter data in this file. So we have to move command mode to insert mode. To move one mode to another mode, we use escape plus I. It will takes you insert mode. Okay. So escape I and enter content. To save this file, come out from insert mode to colon mode. How do we move insert mode to colon mode? Escape, shift to colon, W, Q. W stands for save. Q stands for quit and exclamatory mark with confirmation. To see the content of this file, we use cat file1. See, this is the content. And next important one, last one is nano command. Nano is rarely used command. Nano is rarely used editor. Rarely used editor. In nano, compared to vi, it is not user friendly. Vi is a user friendly editor, so nano is not that much user friendly. We need to enter commands for multiple modes. Let's see, create a file by using nano command, nano, and file name file2. Sorry, nano file2. See, this is not user friendly mode. Vi is a user friendly mode. Enter content. Okay, to save this file, see the options here, control O, it will write and come out. So if you want to cut, we use this control K. If you want to move cursor position, we use control C. If you want next phase, we use control V. Like this, we use multiple commands. I want what? Save and come out. Control O. It will save file. It will ask confirmation. Yes. It will write file. If you want to come out from this nano editor, control X. If you want to see the content of file, cat file2. So we got data. So you got clear information, right? How to create file. So we use cat file, cat command to create file. So by using cat command, we do three operations. We create file, we append content into file, we see the content of file. Touch is used to create multiple files at a time without data. T is a command. We can create multiple files and we can enter content, but content is same. Vi or vim is a editors. So this is visual editors. These are user friendly editor. There you can enter content. Okay. Nano is not that much user friendly. So here, for every operation, we need some commands. Okay. So this is for creating files and to see the content of file. Okay. Thank you.